Welcome to the Physics Place, the place to learn about physics. And in this video, I'm going to explain how you can draw an image using a diverging lens. If you want to draw an image with a lens, you need three principal rays. Before we start there, we first need a lens and an object, and we will draw the image from this object with this lens. Therefore, we need the optical center and the principal axis going through the optical center. And we need the two focus points, one to the right and one to the left, both with the same focal length. And now we can draw the three principal rays. The first one goes through the optical center and its direction is unchanged, so it looks like this. The second principal ray goes parallel to the principal axis, then it goes through the lens and away from the principal axis as if from the focal point, so as if from this point. So if you want to draw it, you need a ruler and you can put it like this so that you draw it away from the principal axis as if it came from the focus point. The third principal ray will go to the focus point on the other side of the lens. So it tries to go to that focus point on the other side of the lens. But when it hits the lens, it will not go through, straight through, but it will go parallel to the principal axis and it looks like this. As you can see, the three principal rays don't intersect with each other on the other side of the lens, but they do intersect with each other on the left side of the lens where the object is. If you draw the blue one a little bit back, you will see that they all intersect in this point, and this is where the image will be. So the image is on the same side as the object. So now you constructed the image with the three principal rays. If you have now a random ray hitting the lens, it will go through the lens as if from this image. So it will go this way. And here it will go as from this image, go that way. So all the light which hit the lens will go in this direction. Now let's see what happens if the lens is smaller. So as you can see now, the lens is a bit smaller and we can draw the image with this lens. The first ray will go through the optical center and it will go unchanged. The second one will go parallel to the principal axis and there it doesn't hit the lens. But as this is a principal ray, you can just make the lens a bit bigger. Now it will go as if from the focus on the left side. So it will go from this. So the lens is too small for this ray to be real, but as we are using it for a principal ray, we are allowed to make the lens a bit bigger. The third principal ray will go to the focus on the other side and then parallel to the principal axis. To determine the image, we have to draw this one back and we can see that the image is here. So with a smaller lens, the image is at the same position. And remember, with principal rays, you are allowed to make the lens a bit bigger if needed. There now will be three example questions to see if you understand. Determine which of these light rays are principal rays. So try that for yourself and pause the video. So we will start with the black one. The black one does not come in parallel and it doesn't go out parallel and it also doesn't go through the optical center, so it's not a principal ray. The yellow one does go through the optical center, it's unchanged, so it is a principal ray. The pink one does not come in parallel, doesn't go out parallel, so it's not a principal ray. The blue one is a principal ray. It comes in parallel, it then goes from the principal axis, so it is a principal ray. And finally, the purple one doesn't come in parallel to the principal axis, doesn't go out parallel to the principal axis, doesn't go through the optical center, so it's not a principal ray. Now we're going to the second example. Determine which light rays are principal and which one are real. This is a very difficult one, so if you don't get it the first try, it doesn't matter as long as you understand it afterwards. You can try it now for yourself and pause the video. So first we determine which ones are the principal rays. The black one starts here in the middle of the flame, it goes to the lens and then it goes parallel. So that seems to be correct. To determine if it's really a principal ray, we have to draw this one back and you see that it hits here the same spot as where it came from. So this one is a principal ray. Now the yellow one. The yellow one starts parallel, then it goes away and if we draw it back, we see that it hits the top here. It also came from the top, so this one is also a principal ray. Now the pink one. The pink one starts here, it doesn't go horizontally here, it doesn't go horizontally here or parallel to the principal axis, so it's not a principal ray. The same for the blue one, it doesn't go parallel to the principal axis here, it doesn't go parallel here, it does not go through the optical center, so it's not a principal ray. And finally the purple one. The purple one goes here parallel, but if you would draw this one here to the back, it does not hit the image, so it's not a principal ray. Now let's see which light rays are real. We start with the black one. The black one is a principal ray and it goes through the lens, so it's also a real one. The yellow one is a principal ray, but it doesn't go through the lens, so this one will actually not be used to construct this image, so it's not a real light ray because it's not going through the lens. We did use it to construct or draw this image, but it's not a real light ray because it will just continue unbent because it's not hitting the lens. The pink one is not a real light ray. Because this is a negative lens or a diverging lens, this one should have been diverted away from the principal axis, but it's now going towards the principal axis, so this is not a real light ray. Now the blue one. The blue one comes from here, so from the middle of the candle, and then to determine if it's a real one, we need to draw this one back. If we draw it back, we can see that it also hits the middle of the image. So as it starts here and it ends here at the same point, it is a real light ray. And finally, the purple one, same as the pink one, it should be going away from the principal axis, but it's going more toward than it was in the beginning, so it's not a real light ray. This was a difficult example. If you didn't get it the first time, it doesn't matter, as long as you now understand why these are the answers. And we are now going to our third example. Copy this drawing and construct the image. So copy this one with the arrow of 2.5 centimeters, 8.5 centimeters away from the negative lens, and with a focus point 3.5 centimeters from this lens. So you can copy this, you can draw it yourself, and I will give you the answer. So first, you also need to draw the other focus point, and it's on the other side of the lens, also 3.5 centimeters away from the lens. So that's over here. Now you can construct the image. The first principal ray goes through the optical center and is unchanged. The second principal ray goes parallel to the principal axis and then it goes away as from this focus. And the third principal ray goes to this focus point, and when it hits the lens, it will continue on parallel. We have where they all three intersect, so this is where our image will be. If you want to check if you did it correctly, this should be roughly 2.5 centimeters away from the lens, and this would have roughly a height of 0.7 centimeters. That's it. You should now know how to draw an image with a diverging lens. If you found this video helpful, please let me know by liking and subscribe for more videos. Thanks for watching.